So let's start the discussion of the bandwidth of FM and PM signals in context of a little bit of theory. It says that the bandwidth of different AM modulation techniques ranges from the bandwidth of message signal. So what this means is that for SSB, if the message signal was having a bandwidth of 1B, so the modulated signal would have, for SSB, would have the bandwidth equivalent to 1B itself. So there will be no change. But if it is VSB scheme that you're using, then depending on the characteristic of the filter that you would use at the transmitter and receiver, or at the transmitter, so you may have a bandwidth in the range of around 1.25B. And if you are simply sending it by means of an AM, then that would be 2B. FM signal inception, so when it was first proposed, it was thought that the bandwidth can be reduced to an arbitrarily small value. The frequency deviation, which we call as delta F, it was initially thought that we actually need to send only this deviation, this bandwidth would be required to send a message signal. But this was later on proved to be wrong. Experimentally, we will talk about it by means of mathematics, how the bandwidth of narrow band, which is basically having less bandwidth than the standard FM or the wideband FM, still that is equivalent to at least AM. So it was discovered that the bandwidth of FM signals for a specific message signal was at least equal to the bandwidth of the corresponding AM signal. So we will focus next on two aspects of FM, which is narrowband FM and wideband FM. For narrowband FM, let's just jump to this condition first. It says that if this condition, that sensitivity constant Kf multiplied by A of t, I will discuss about that, if it is much smaller than 1, then it would dictate that the modulation scheme is narrowband FM. If it is not, then that would mean it is wideband FM. Right. So originally we know that the modulated signal, the frequency modulated signal, is equal to A times cos the instantaneous frequency omega ct plus the sensitivity parameter Kf integration of minus infinity to t m of alpha d alpha. This is a message signal. This message signal passes through an integrator, multiplies with the sensitivity constant Kf, and then you add with the carrier frequency to actually transmit the modulated signal. This aspect is basically for notational simplicity, we have mentioned it as A of t. So this is starting at minus infinity and going until t. So if you are assuming that there is no initial value, so you may you set the initial condition to 0, so you may start from 0 to t and then you become m of alpha t alpha. Right. So you may perturb this thing. Right. So what does it reflect? So it reflects that this whole thing, if it is very small, it is not going to play a significant role in changing the carrier frequency. So if it is not going to play a very significant role, then that is basically narrowband FM. Whatever is the carrier frequency, the modulated signal would be very near to it. The perturbation because of the message signal will not be that much. So this is basically a primary condition for the narrowband FM. Whenever you are posed with a modulation scheme, and if you are asked whether the given scheme follows is a narrowband FM or not, so you would just have to check this. So as I mentioned, that we are going to prove mathematically the bandwidth of FM. So let's start with the message, frequency modulated signal GFM of t. This is A cos omega ct plus Kf sensitivity constant t times 80. Remember, 80 is simply this integration of the message signal, Kf of 80. So in order to determine the bandwidth of the modulated signal, so we would go to an indirect approach. And by that indirect approach, what I mean is that if we have this gfm of t, we can say we take a real part of e j. Let me just write theta here. So that would be equal to cos theta, because from the Euler's identity, e j theta is cos theta plus j sine theta. So if you take the real part of it, you will just get cos theta, and this is that we need here, and this is the generic angle. What we have identified over here is basically the motivation for a new definition or a new signal. We call it as g hat fm of t, right? So if you take the real part of this, you would eventually get g fm. We simply get a exponential j and this argument omega ct plus kf a of t. So omega ct plus kf a of t, and from the property that e a plus b is equal to e a times e b, so we have simply a e j omega ct times e exponential of j kf a of t. Now this is the first exponential is a constant. It is not varying. This plays the most significant role. Why it plays a significant role? Because Kf A of T was, this was basically used in the assumption when we said that the absolute value of Kf A of T should be much, much less than 1, should be smaller. So our next analysis would be dependent on the exponential term, which is the second exponential term, ejkf times a of t. So next, what we do is we expand this exponential term. And how do we expand it? It's a simple Taylor series. If you have something like e raised to power x, you may expand it like this. N is the coefficient, so you would have x power n over n factorial. So what we do is we simply write a over here, and then ej omega ct, which was from here, and then we expand ej kf a of t in this bracket. So this would be, if you expand this exponential, you would simply have, first you put n equal to 0, you would get simply 1, and then if you put n equal to 1, you would get a value of x, which is simply this whole thing, jkf a of t, jkf a of t, and then some higher order terms. So next, what we can do is we can bring the exponential inside. So this exponential now multiplied with all the terms. So this is e j omega ct j kf a of t e j omega ct, and so on. A simplification that you can do is you can just simply say, since this is true, so that would mean this term is smaller, this is small, this is much smaller, this is even smaller, and we can say that all of them are simply higher order terms. And this is a converging series, this is not a diverging series. Why is it converging? Because this coefficient is getting smaller and smaller. So another way of looking at this, how it converges is, let's move to one step further and say that we now go back to our original signal, which is GFM of T, which is the real part of G hat FM of T, and that is equivalent to A. If we take the real part of this, so we would simply have cos omega CT. If we take the real part of this, there's a J here, and then you have EJ omega CT. So J E J omega CT, this is equal to J cos omega CT plus J square, this whole thing, sine omega CT. This will become minus. This is now complex because of this J. So if you take the real part, this will vanish and you would simply be left with this one. So you would have E minus KF A of T sine omega CT minus KF square A square of T by 2 factorial. Now this EJ omega CT would again give you a cos omega CT. So remember that cos function is oscillating between minus 1 and plus 1. So this, the range of this cos function would be between minus 1 and plus 1. But at the same time, this is much smaller. Since this is much smaller, if it is multiplied with any value which is in between minus 1 and plus 1, so it will still be smaller. So all these terms would be, the higher order terms can be cancelled because they are not contributing to the summation. So what we can say is, we can change this equality into an approximation. Why so? Because we have got the first term, which is this one. We got the second term, which is this one. And then we have removed the higher order terms. So the transmitted or the modulated signal GFM narrowband of T is A cos omega CT minus KF A of T sine omega CT. Now when we need to construct this narrowband FM, remember this is narrowband, this is not for a generic FM. So when we are constructing this, we can start with a message signal. We have a message signal if you pass it through an integrator. So the output of that integrator would be simply A of T. For example, if we have a single tone signal, this is a message signal which is single tone. If we observe this, so at zero it is having a value of 1. So if we integrate it, so the outcome would be a sine function. So if you look over here, this is basically representing a sine function. So this is the output of an integrator. So you would have that output A of T, which is a function of time. So this A of T would then be multiplied with sine omega CT. So because in the modulation in AM and FM, so far we start usually with cos omega CT. So we start with cos omega CT. We give a phase shift of minus pi by 2. So it will become sine omega CT. If we give a phase shift of plus pi by 2, we would have a minus sine omega CT. So right now we are just giving sine omega CT. We just intend to get sine omega CT. So A of T would be multiplied with sine omega CT because of this modulator. Then it would be multiplied with an amplifier, which we term as sensitivity parameter KF. And over here we have an addition of cos omega CT and a subtraction of KF A of T sine omega CT in this summer. Remember, if you use a plus here, you would need a plus here, but then the sine would be having the negative sign over here, right? So eventually we pass it through another amplifier, which we termed as A, and then this is A cos omega CT minus KF A of T sine omega CT. Similarly, if we have PM, the construction of narrowband PM, so if this is the new condition, the sensitivity parameter KP used for the phase modulation multiplied by the message signal. Previously, we multiplied with the integration of the message signal, but right now we are multiplying with the message signal itself. So KP multiplied by the message signal, if it is much, much smaller than 1, right? So the forthcoming expression will hold. That is that the G PM narrow band of T is approximately equal to A times cos omega CT minus KP M of T rather than the integration of M of T times sin omega CT. So we get rid of the integration block over here. So we have a message signal. We start with cos omega CT. It will pass through a phase shift of minus pi by 2. So we'll get a sin omega CT over here. Eventually we get the narrowband PM